Today we're going to be learning about speaker placement and the best places to put speakers around the room. I've just bought some bookshelf speakers that look like this and a random amplifier like this, and I'm going to try and put them together and make my TV sound really freaking sick. Dude, let's get into it. I came into the subject pretty ignorant, so I didn't really know what I was doing. So I really learned a lot yesterday when I bought all this sort of stuff. So I bought these bookshelf speakers. I thought you just plugged them in and then they were good to go, but no, that didn't happen. It looked like this on the back. All right, and it just had two inputs. Now these are called passive speakers. They need power from somewhere to work. If you don't have any power, where does that come from? If you can't plug it into the wall, where's the power come from? And that comes from something they call an amplifier or a receiver. Now I didn't know that yesterday, so I just went out and bought an amplifier. So I've just got this big bad boy over here amplifying my sound, pushing power to my speakers. But it probably wasn't the best option for me to get. I probably wanted a receiver. Now we're gonna be working with the placement of all the speakers and seeing how I can get the best possible sound from my speakers. Before we get into a setup montage, I'm gonna get into an isosceles triangle theory, or whatever you call it, for placement of speakers. And that means that the speakers themselves are the same distance apart as they are from the listener. Let's get into it. Hell yeah. So I'm gonna put this chair in the middle, and then that should be a sort of mid-ground for the chairs. Now what I'm gonna try and do is get my tape measure and try and figure out the placement of where I should have them. Like, how far apart are they? How far do I need to be back from the TV? Because I reckon I've got a pretty good in the center look here. Check that bad boy out, right in the middle. Looks freaking good. Now I just need to set up the speakers. And after that, it should be fine, right? That's how easy everything is, right? Okay, let's get into it. Where I'm standing now is where my ears should be. Ooh, this is sick. I think I've set them up right. I'm gonna give them a sound test and then we'll see how it goes from there. That was easy. I got no idea what sound is supposed to sound like or whatever. So I'm just gonna take it as it is and then see if it's better than the TV. And if it is, I've done my job. All right, let's test it out. All right, so I compared audios, the one from my TV and the one from my speakers. Massive improvement, really enjoy it. Love my new setup. And hopefully I can learn a little bit more about placement and audio and mixing and see what I can do from there. Hey, top tips from today's lesson. There's different types of speakers. If you buy speakers that look like this with no power in them, they need to be powered. They're called passive speakers. So to power them, you need an amplifier or a AV receiver. Those things connect to your speakers with speaker cable, the red and white copper looking things, and power the speakers. The next thing is, when you're setting up your placement of the speakers, think about an isosceles triangle. That isosceles triangle is going to be a perfect triangle between you and your two speakers. If your speakers are 2 meters apart, you want to be 2 meters apart from each speaker as well. So you're getting the perfect amount of to the ears, if that makes sense. Just remember, passive speakers need power, amplifiers or receivers power them, and try and get the isosceles triangle within your space. Okay, I learned something today, and I hope you did too. I'll see you later.